Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the solution and discussion of gate question paper in mechanical engineering subjects. And this is lecture number 45. We are going to discuss the solution for gate question papers, gate questions in the subject fluid mechanics in the topic fluid static and pressure measurement. So we are continuing with the earlier lecture. In the earlier lecture also we solved gate questions in the topic fluid static and pressure measurement. We continue with that topic. So this question is from gate 2014. A spherical balloon with a diameter of 10 meter shown below in the figure is used for advertisement. The balloon is filled with helium of gas constant R equal to 2.08 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin at ambient condition of 15 degrees Celsius and 100 kilopascal. Assuming no disturbance due to the wind, the maximum allowable weight in Newton of balloon material and rope required to avoid the fall of the balloon. So you take R, gas constant for the air, 0.289 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So we have to write the weight of the balloon material and the rope in Newton. So the answer is 5306 Newton. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, this is the balloon of radius 5 meter. It is filled with helium. And the total weight of the balloon is weight of the balloon material plus weight of the helium. And the balloon is subjected to the upward force because of the helium. It is having upward pull and it is having downward force due to the rope. The tension in the rope, it maintains, it will give the downward force. When the two forces are equal, upward force and the downward force are equal, then the balloon will be staying at a particular location. Now, the density of the gas, rho equal to P by RT. So, we calculate density of the helium, P by R, gas constant and the temperature. Pressure and temperatures are constant. So, 100 kilopascal, so 100 into 1000, 1 lakh divided by 2080 into 288. 15 degrees Celsius is 288. So, density of helium is 0.167 kilograms per meter cube. Density of air, P by R for the air into temperature. So, 1 lakh divided by 289 into 288 equal to 1.2 kilogram per meter cube. Volume of the balloon, V equal to 4 by 3 pi R cube. So, 4 by 3 pi into 5 to the power 3 equal to 523.33 meter cube. So, under limiting equilibrium, tension on the rope equal to 0. So, the weight of the balloon plus rope equal plus weight of the helium plus rope equal to the upward force by the air. So, the force by the air. So, weight of the balloon plus rope, weight of the helium plus weight tension on the rope. So, we said tension on the rope equal to 0. Tension on the rope equal to 0. So, weight of the balloon plus rope into weight of the helium. Weight of the helium equal to density of the helium. Volume of the balloon, because the helium is filled within the balloon, so volume of the balloon into G, that is equal to the FB of air, so that is equal to density of air, volume of the balloon into acceleration due to gravity. So, we have to calculate weight of the balloon plus rope, that is equal to, rearranging the terms, density of air minus density of helium into volume of the balloon into G, acceleration due to gravity, substituting 1.2 minus 0.167. So, density of air and the helium we calculated earlier. So, 1.2 minus 0.167 into 523.33 into 9.81. So, this is equal to 5306 Newton. So, the weight of the balloon plus rope equal to 5306 Newton. The next question from 2014 question paper. An inverted U-tube manometer is used to measure the pressure difference between two pipes A and B, as shown in the figure. So, we have the pipe A where the oil is flowing and pipe B where the water is flowing and the air is the manometric fluid. Pipe A is carrying oil of specific gravity 0.8 and pipe B is carrying water. The densities of air and the water are 1.16 kilogram per meter cube and 1000 kilogram per meter cube respectively. The pressure difference between the pipe A and pipe B is dash kilopascal. So, the acceleration due to gravity, we take g equal to 10 meter per second square. So, now the answer is 2.2 kilopascal. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, this is the manometer and this is the reference point. So the air, actually this line is the reference point. So writing the manometric equation, PA minus density of oil G, acceleration due to gravity into 0.2. 0.2 is the height. So 200 millimeter equal to 0.2 minus density of the air into G into 0.08. 80 millimeter is the density of height of the air column, plus on the right side density of water. So rho W into G into 0.38. So this is 100 plus 200 plus 380. So 0.38 minus PB. Minus PB equal to 0. So calculating. So substituting the values, 800 into G is 10 now. So G is 10 into 0.2. 1.16 into 10 into 0.08. 1000 into 10 into 0.38 minus PB. So PB minus PA equal to 2199 Pascal. Or 2.2 kilopascal. That is the answer. So we have to calculate the pressure difference in kilopascal. The answer is 2.2 kilopascal. The next question is from 2016 question paper. The large vessel is shown in the figure contains oil and water. The body is submerged at the interface of the oil and the water such that 45% of its volume is in the oil while the rest in water. The density of the body is dash kilogram per meter cube. The specific gravity of the oil is 0.7 and density of water is 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Take acceleration due to gravity as 10 meter per second square. So this is the metallic body. So it is submerged here. So top is oil, bottom is water. So 45% of volume in the oil, remaining is in the water. What is the density of the metallic body? So to retain the position as such. The answer is 865 kilogram per meter cube. So we will see how in the next slide. So this is the diagram once again. So the equating the balance rho B, density of the metallic body into G into volume equal to rho oil into acceleration due to gravity into 0.45 times of the volume, because 45% is in the oil. So plus rho W G into 0.55 times of the volume. So 55% is in the water. Now here G is getting cancelled, V is getting cancelled. What is left out? Rho B equal to, so we have on the right hand side density of the oil 700 into 0.45 plus 1000, density of water is 1000 plus 0.55, which is 865 kilogram per metric cube. That is the answer to the problem. The next question is also from 2016 question paper. Consider a frictionless, massless and leak proof blocking of rectangle hole of dimension 2R into L. So this is the rectangular hole of dimension 2R. So 2R is the radius. So 2R is the radius into L at the bottom of an open tank as shown in the figure. So this is radius. So this radius equal to R. So this length equal to, so this is the side view, this is the front view of the, this is the rectangular hole of length L and this is the radius of the rectangular hole. So the width is shown in the side view. So 2R is the width. 2R is the width. So width into length at the bottom of the open tank as shown in the figure. The head of a plug has a shape of the semicylinder of radius R. So we have a plugging element. The tank is filled with a liquid of density rho up to the top of the plug. So look at here. So this is the plug, the liquid is here up to the top of the plug. The gravitational acceleration is G. Neglecting the effect of atmospheric pressure, the force F required to hold the plug in its position. What is the force required to keep the plug in position? So the answer, we have four different answers. A, B, C, D. A is 2 rho R square GL into 1 minus pi by 4. And B is 2 rho r square gl into 1 plus pi by 4. And C is pi r square into rho gl. And D is pi by 2 r square into rho gl. The correct answer is option A. 2 rho r square gl into 1 minus pi by 4. So we will see how in the next slide. So this is the plug alone. So we have the plug of radius r. And we have the force acting here. So the force required to balance the hydrostatic force. So this FV, so FV equal to volume of the rectangle minus volume of the semicircle into rho into G. So FV equal to volume of the rectangle. So this rectangle of height, width 2R, height R and length is L. That is the volume of the rectangle and volume of the semicircle pi R square by 2. into L. L is the length. So pi r square by 2 into L into rho g. So simplifying, we take 2 r square L rho g. 2 r square L. So it will become 2 r square L rho g into 1 minus pi by 4. So the answer, the force acting in the upward direction is 2 r square L rho g into 1 minus pi by 4. Next question is also from 2016 question paper. A 2 by 2, 2 meter by 2 meter square opening in a vertical wall is covered with a metallic plate of same dimension as shown in the figure below. Consider the acceleration due to gravity to be 10 meter per second square. The force exerted by the water on the plate is dash Newton. So we have a vertical wall and we have a square plate of size 2 meter by 2 meter which is closing here. So the height is 2 meter and the height above the gate is 2 meter for the free surface of water. Here the atmospheric pressure is acting. And what is the question is the force exerted by the water on the plate. So that is equal to force exerted by the water on the plate equal to F equal to rho g a into h bar. So rho equal to 1000, g equal to 10, area equal to 2 by 2 and the h bar equal to the height, this 2 meter plus half of the height of the gate. So 2 plus 1 is equal to 120 kilonewton. So the answer is 120 kilonewton. So this h bar equal to half of the height of the plate plus height above the gate to the free surface, 2 plus 1. That is the answer, 120 kilonewton. The next question from 2017 question paper, for the stability of a floating body, the center of buoyancy must coincide with the center of gravity. The center of buoyancy must be above the center of gravity. The center of gravity must be above the center of buoyancy. Meta center must be above the center of gravity. So the answer is, for stability of the floating body, meta center must be above the center of gravity. Option D is the correct answer. The next question is from 2017 gate question paper. A manometer is used to measure for pressure measurement in a closed tank. Three fluids F1, F2, F3 have specific weight gamma, 2 gamma and 0.5 gamma respectively. The schematic arrangement with the manometer reading and other dimensions are shown in the figure. In order to ensure zero gauge pressure in the tank at the mid height h by 2, the height of the tank h is dash meter. So the answer is 2 meter. So first we read the diagram. So we have a U-tube manometer and a closed tank. The tank height is h by 2, center of the height. So what is the question is, in order to ensure zero gauge pressure in the tank at the mid height. So here the gauge pressure at the midpoint, the gauge pressure is zero. What should be the height of the tank? That is the question. And this is one fluid of 0.6 meter height and another manometric fluid. So this is F2 and this is F1 and this is F3. So the answer is 2 meter. We will see how in the next slide. And we redraw the diagram once again. And the P is the point at the mid height level. So this is the point where we measure the gauge pressure and the gauge pressure is equal to 0. Now we write the equation. We write the pressure at the point can be written as P at P equal to. So P atmosphere. So here the atmospheric pressure is acting plus the height gamma into 1.2. So 1.2 meter. So gamma into, this is the datum, gamma into 1.2 minus. So this fluid is of specific gravity 2 gamma. So 2 gamma into 0.2. 2 gamma into 0.2 minus 0.5 into 0.6 plus h by 2. 0.6 plus h by 2. Now we have to calculate the gauge pressure. So P minus P atmosphere equal to gamma. You take gamma is the common parameter. Take it out. So gamma into 1.2 minus 2 into 0.2 minus 0.5 into 0.6 plus h by 2. So simplifying PG. So PP, pressure minus atmospheric pressure. So the absolute pressure minus atmospheric pressure is the gauge pressure, which is gamma into 0.5 minus 0.25 h. So we have PG equal to 0. So we have to calculate the height of the tank when the gauge pressure is 0. So gauge pressure is equal to 0. So substituting gauge pressure equal to 0 in the previous equation, 0 equal to gamma into 0.5 minus 0.25 h. So gamma is deleted now. So 0.5 equal to 0.25 h and h equal to 2 meter. So the height of the tank equal to 2 meter. That is the answer to the problem. The next question from 2019 question paper. A cube of side 100 millimeter is placed at the bottom of an empty container on one of its faces. The density of the material of the cube is 800 kilogram per meter cube. Liquid density is 1000 kilogram per meter cube is now poured into the container. The minimum height to which the liquid needs to be poured into the container for the cube to just lift up is that dash millimeter. So this is the cube. So the cube is here. We have a cube of side A. Now the force normal reaction, the upward force and the downward force. Downward force due to the weight of the cube and upward force is here. And this is the height of the liquid. So the height of the liquid just to lift the cube. So we have to pour the liquid of density 1000 kilogram per meter cube. So what should be the height of the liquid so that the cube will be just lifted. So sigma Fy equal to 0, the vertical force, sum of the vertical forces equal to 0. What are these vertical forces? Fb is vertically upward, W is vertically downward and N is vertically upward. So Fb minus W plus N equal to 0. When the cube is just about to lift, the normal reaction equal to 0. Then only the cube will be just lifting. When normal reaction equal to 0, Fb equal to W. So Fb equal to rho g into volume. So the rho g into volume. So rho g into volume, this equal to rho s. Rho s is the density of the solid, v into g into vs. Vs is the density of the solid material. So rho equal to density of the fluid, which is 1000. Area g is 9, g is getting cancelled here. So volume equal to a square into h. So the volume of the liquid equal to a square into h. Then on the other side, density of the metal 800 into a square into a, that is the volume of the metal block. So a square is getting cancelled. So this will be h equal to 0.8 times of a. So a is the side of the cube, which is given as 100 millimeter. So 0.8 into 100 equal to 80 millimeter. So the answer is 80 millimeter. We have to fill the liquid up to 80 millimeter height so that when you pour water above 80 millimeter, it will be just lifted. It will be lifted from the bottom surface. Next question is also from 2019 question paper. A open tank of 2 meter by 2 meter by 2 meter is filled with the layers of 2 fluid. The depth of each layer is 1 meter. The top layer is that of an oil of specific gravity 0.8. The bottom layer is water. Consider the density of water is 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Acceleration due to gravity is 9.8 meter per second square. Neglecting the effect of atmosphere pressure, the force exerted by the fluid on one side of the wall of the tank is dash Newton. The answer is 33,320 Newton. We will see how in the next slide. So this is the wall. So 2 meter height, one side is 2 meter height and the width equal to 2 meter. And other dimension, all the three dimensions are 2 meter. Size equal to 2 meter by 2 meter by 2 meter. So, one side is given here. Oil density. So, the top layer 1 meter height oil, another bottom 1 meter height is water. So, here the force is acting F1, here the force is acting F2. So, the oil density is 800 kilogram per meter cube. Water density is 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Acceleration due to gravity G equal to 9.8 meter per second square. The force exerted by the two fluid on the one side of the wall of the tank. So we have to calculate F1 equal to PCG into area. So P is the pressure acting at the center of gravity into area. So P is pressure equal to 800 into 9.8 into 0.5. So this is the pressure into area equal to 1 into 2. So area equal to 1 is the height, 1 meter is the height of the oil and 2 is the another dimension, vertical perpendicular to the board. So pressure equal to density rho g into h, that is the pressure acting at the center of gravity. So rho g into h is the 0.5 times of the total height. So 7840 Newton. F2, then force acting here, F2 equal to, this is PCG into area. So this here we have the total force due to the oil column. So 800 into 9.8 into 1 plus 1000 into 9.8 to 0.5 into area is 1 into 2. So, 1 is the height and 2 is the dimension perpendicular to the paper. So, which is 25,480 Newton. So, the total force F equal to F1 plus F2, which is 7,840 plus 25,480 equal to 33,320 Newton. That is the answer to the problem. Next question from 1998 question paper. A cylinder of mass 10 kilogram and the area of cross section 0.1 meter square is tied down with a string in a vessel containing two liquids as shown in the figure. So, we have the metal cylinder of mass 10 kilogram of area 0.1 meter square. We have two fluid A and fluid B. Fluid A is of height 0.1 meter, fluid B of height 0.1.2 meter. The solid block, the cylinder is tied with the bottom with a string. So, calculate the gauge pressure on the cylinder bottom and the tension in the string. So, density of water is 1000 kilograms per meter cube. Specific gravity of liquid A is 0.8. Specific gravity of the liquid B is 1. So, the answer to the question, tension in the string equal to 103 Newton and the pressure, gauge pressure at the bottom equal to 2011 Newtons per meter square. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, yeah, again the same diagram, we redrawn the diagram again. So, now we calculate mass of the cylinder is 10 kilogram, area of the cylinder is 0.1 meter square, density of water is 1000 kilogram per meter cube, density of the liquid A 0.8 into 1000 equal to 800 kilogram per meter cube, density of liquid B 1 into 1000 equal to 1000 kilogram per meter cube. This is all the data given. Now, mass of the liquid, mass of liquid A displaced by the body. So, what is the quantity of mass of the liquid displaced by the body? Equal MA equal to rho A into VA. Rho A equal to 800 into volume of the liquid A is 0.1 into 0.1. So, area is 0.1, height equal to 0.1. So, 0.1 into 0.1 equal to 8 kilogram. Mass of the liquid B displaced by the body. So, again MB equal to rho B into VB. Rho B equal to 1000, VB equal to area is 0.1, height equal to 0.125, which is 12.5 kilogram. So, total mass of the liquid displaced 8 plus 12.5 equal to 20.5 kilogram. Then the upward thrust, that is equal to weight of the liquid displaced. So, weight of the liquid displaced equal to mass into acceleration due to gravity, 20.5 into 9.82 equal to 201.1 Newton. So, the weight of the cylinder equal to 10 into 9.81, which is 98.1 Newton. So, net upward thrust equal to, that is equal to tension in the string equal to the upward thrust minus weight of the cylinder, 201.1 minus 98.1 equal to 103 Newton, and the gauge pressure equal to net upward thrust divided by the area. So, 103 divided by 0.1 equal to 2011 Newtons per meter square. That is the answer. So, the upward thrust equal to the tension in the string equal to 203 Newton and the gauge pressure at the bottom equal to 2011 Newtons per meter square. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in the mechanical engineering subject. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects and the gate question paper in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel and use the videos for your better learning. And thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can write to me to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. We'll meet again with another video lecture in the solution of gate question paper in the subject field mechanics and machines. Until then, bye-bye.